Okay. All right, guys. So today, I know we said we were going to go through the life of Jesus because we did like an overview, right? But looking at it, I was like, it's a little repetitive in some areas. So we thought we'd take a break from that. And since it is Palm Sunday, which some of you are like, I don't know what that is, don't worry. That's why we're talking about it today. We're going to do a special on Palm Sunday. Now, all of you know when Easter is, right? I hope you all know Easter, okay? We all know the reason. Well, I hope we all know the reasons for Easter. It's because Jesus died and he rose again on Easter, okay? So, but the Sunday or the week before, Jesus had this, like, triumphant entry, okay? You see the Jesus's triumphant entry into a town called Jerusalem. All right, so we're going to go through that because it's Palm Sunday, so we're going to like jump back in history as if it was that time if we were doing that, okay? So I want you guys to go to Luke 19, all right? And it's going to be verse 28, all right? I'll give you a second to get there. We're pretty much just going to stay in this right here area. So not a lot of flipping around today. That's kind of nice. Get to stay. And then, yeah. So are you there? Okay. Good. Hopefully you'll find it. All right. So verse 28, chapter 19. When he had said this, he went on ahead, going up to Jerusalem. So Jesus, he had just finished talking about a parable. All right. And so after he said this, he was going to Jerusalem. Now it came to pass when he drew near to Bethphage, maybe they don't pronounce the PH, I don't know, and Bethany at the mountain called Olivet, or Olive, whatever, that he sent two of his disciples, saying, okay, so they get to this place that I can't pronounce very well, and he tells his disciples, well, I have to tell you. Okay, so he tells his disciples, go into the village opposite of you, and where, as you enter, you will find a colt. A colt is like a young donkey or young mule, okay? Or young horse. I think it was a donkey in this case. You'll find this young colt tied, on which no one has ever sat. Loose it and bring it to me. So, how many of you have ever ridden a horse? How many of you have ever ridden any type of animal, like a donkey? Sometimes people ride goats. I had goats. I would ride my goats. You know, jump on them, go, and fall off. Okay? But a lot of people ride horses or mules, okay? Now, do you know how hard it is to train a horse or a mule when they're young to be rideable? It's not easy. It takes a lot of time, and they have to get knowing you. They have to trust you, or there's the other way of doing it where you just are really mean to them. But, okay, you usually gain their animal's trust and then you can ride them, you know. But it takes a lot of time, a lot of work, a lot of practice. There are people who do it professionally because you can't just jump on a horse and expect it to ride like a racehorse, okay? It's going to buck you off, all right? So Jesus tells them, he says, go into this village, all right? And there should be a colt tied up that no one's ever ridden. Okay, this is like in the horse people's terms, it's green, okay? This is a green horse. It doesn't know anything. It's a total doesn't know, okay? So, they're like, so no one's ever ridden on it, and I want you to bring it here. So you're just like going into a village, find some colt tied up, take it to Jesus, right? And then he says, if anyone asks you, why are you loosening it? Or like, why are you taking this colt? You shall say to him, because the Lord has need of it. All right? So those who were sent went their way and found it just as he had said to them. Now, I'm sure that those two guys who were sent were probably kind of like, okay, this is weird. But, you know, a lot of things Jesus tells us are weird. But we do them, and they always turn out right. So I guess it's just going to turn out right. Okay? So they just went. All right? They go and they do that. So, but as they were loosening the colt, so they're untying the colt and they're going to take it to Jesus, the owners of it said, why are you loosening the colt? They're like, excuse me, what are you doing? And then they said, the Lord has need of him. So they were like, well, the Lord has need of him. And the owners just, I guess they were okay with it, you know? They're like, I guess, all right. So then they brought him to Jesus, the colt, and they threw their own clothes on the colt, and they set Jesus on him. All right? So saddles are nice because saddles help you stay on the animals. Saddles also make it way more comfortable to stay on a horse or a colt. Okay, they didn't really have saddles back then. Different kinds. But they used like more like blankets, you know, or a thick, tough blanket kind of. So that's what I'm assuming they used. So they didn't have that because Jesus obviously didn't own any horses or colts. And I'm assuming none of the disciples did. Okay, so when they get this colt and bring it in, they put their coats on. Like, we're going to cushion this. We're going to make this more comfortable, easier to ride the colt, right? Okay, so anyways, Jesus, they put Jesus on the colt, okay? And as he went, many spread their clothes on the road. All right, so Jesus is riding in on this colt. Disciples are walking beside him. It's like this. Well, I just probably walked out of the screen. Okay, it's like this entire, like, parade. You guys have been to a parade, right? Yes, I hope you have. If not, that's so sad. You should go. It's super fun. They throw candy, and you get to eat it. Okay, so anyways, have any of you ever been in a parade? That's true. I've been in a parade. It's great. You're just like, yeah! Okay? But this was like a parade, and Jesus was like the center. Or imagine like someone super famous is walking down the street. Everyone's just like, oh yeah, we're going with that guy. He's so cool. That was Jesus. Jesus is walking down the street, all right? And, you know, usually in a parade, you throw things out, like candy, or some people throw out, like, pens or pencils, erasers, you know? But these people were throwing things to Jesus instead of having things come to him, to them, okay? They were laying down their coats in the road. They were like, okay, you know when you have a king? Have you seen the movies? And they have, like, this red carpet, and the people walk in, or they put a red carpet down in the street, or, you know, like, when people get married, they put down, like, a carpet of roses, because it's like, wow, this is someone who's really important, and they weren't going to step on important ground, okay? So these people, as Jesus is riding in to Jerusalem, to the city, all these people who know, these people that know about Jesus, they're all coming around, and they're throwing down their coats on the ground. And as he was now drawing near the desert mountain of Olives, the whole multitude of disciples began to rejoice and praise the God with a loud voice and all the mighty works they had seen. Okay, so they're walking, and then all of a sudden the disciples are just like, they start praising. Verse 38, blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord, peace in heaven and glory in the highest. Okay, that's what they're saying. They're just like, blessed be the Lord, peace, glory. Yeah, okay? And these people, they're throwing down their coats. I think in some translations, let me jump over to Matthew and look. It talks about the reason why we call it Palm Sunday, okay? Dun, dun, dun. Okay, so Matthew says, so Luke says, well, we were saying, blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord, peace in heaven, glory and highest. But Matthew says, we were saying, Hosanna to the Son of David, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. Okay, and then I'll just read this from Matthew 21:10. And when he had come into Jerusalem, all the city was moved, saying, who is this? So the multitudes said, this is Jesus, the prophet from Nazareth in Galilee. Okay? So these people are just coming in, and they're like, who is this guy? Because people are making a big deal. Okay, here's the reason why. Okay, we call it Palm Sunday. Here's the verse, okay? Verse 8, 21 verse 8 in Matthew. And a very great multitude multitudes spread their clothes on the road. Others cut down branches from trees and spread them on the road. And the multitude went forward as they followed and cried out, "The Hosanna, Son of David," or like what Luke said, "Blessed is the King." Okay, so people, they were throwing down their coats, but then they're going and they're cutting down branches. Now, I think a lot of people, it might say in another gospel, remember the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, those are the Gospels because they record the good news of Jesus, okay? It might say for sure like that they were palm branches or palm trees. I'm not quite certain. I could look it up. I'm just going to go with it, though. Okay, they're cutting down the branches, and they throw them in the road, throwing their coats. They're going after Jesus, and they're like, "Yeah, yeah, yeah." Okay, it is literally like a parade or a convoy. You see a king come into a king into a place, and all these people come in after him. Okay, or like I said, a famous person. You got the paparazzi, the people with the cameras. You got their managers. You got their bodyguards in the suits. You got the people to do their hair and their makeup and their clothes and their shoes. And then you got just the crazy fans who are like, "Ah!" And then you got, you know, they're like friends who are like, "Yeah, dude, this is great," okay? All right, so like, that's like almost like what it was like when Jesus came in, except it was more of like a, It wasn't necessarily like a, "Look at me." It was like, they were just like, "Yeah." It was like this whole thing, the whole city is just like, stirred up. Everyone's like, "Who is this? What's going on?" They're like, "That's Jesus, the prophet." Okay? So, let me go back to Luke real quick. So they go into the temple, making such a big deal, right? And they go in, and guess what? It says, "And some of the Pharisees called to him from the crowd, 'Teacher, rebuke your disciples.' And he answered and said to them, 'I tell you that if these should keep silent, the stones will immediately cry out.'" Okay? Jesus was like, God has appointed this time for praise. Okay? If they stop singing, the rocks will start singing. You can't ask me to be quiet. Ask them to be quiet. They're doing what they're going to do. God has chosen this time. He was like, I'm not. The Pharisees were jealous, okay? The Pharisees had been the people who had been getting all the attention all the time long. You know, why haven't I been writing this on the board? I'm slacking, guys, honestly. Okay, so we have Jesus, right? We have Jesus and his cult. Wow, this is going to be a bad drawing. Okay, and then Jesus is sitting on here. Yeah. Right? Okay. Kind of got some scrawny arms and scrawny legs, but that's all right. We got it, okay? Okay, and then there's just like, this is all people, okay? And they're just coming. And then all these other people are throwing down their coats, right? That was bad. And the palm leaves or whatever, okay? And they're going, right? We got all that. Got the clothes, the robes, whatever you want to call them. That looks like a T, but oh well. Okay, and they're going to the city. Dun, 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 dun. This is the entry. We're just gonna call this Jerusalem. Okay, so this is Jerusalem. They're going, there's all these people, la da da da, on all the sides. They're all crying out, "Yeah, yeah, yeah, okay." The Pharisees are over here. "Teacher, you need to tell them to stop." And Jesus is like, "No, I don't think so," right? So the Pharisees were very jealous because they were the people who thought that they knew it all. They literally thought that. They thought that they were perfect. They knew it all. Guys, if you think you know it all and you think you're perfect, I hate to break it to you, you're not, okay? And God's going to have to humble you. But, okay, so we have these Pharisees, and they're just, like, super upset, okay? Because Jesus is getting all this attention. He's getting proclaimed as, like, amazing. And they're super jealous. They're like, what about us? What about all the things we've done? Mm-mm. The Pharisees were very blinded, okay? So anyways, they're pretty jealous. And then they come up with this scheme. They come up with this terrible scheme to kill Jesus. I mean, they wanted to before that. Remember we read they were plotting. But now they were like, oh, this guy didn't just get some people to follow him or get some people to sit down and listen to his teaching. Now he's got the whole city out there proclaiming his name, throwing down their coats. It's gone too far, okay? And then we all know the story. Jesus is betrayed. He dies. Okay? He dies, yeah. Jesus dies. But 3 days later, he rises from the dead. Holy Spirit raises him back up, okay? He didn't stay dead, because if he stayed dead, that would be bad. And you're going to find out next week, okay? There's not going to be a live stream next week. It's going to be just, if you want to know, it's going to be the service out there. Or you can go back, way back to like last year and watch the one we did last year. But I would encourage you to watch the one that Pastor Tom's going to do, okay? Okay, but this is what happened on Palm Sunday. Like a long time ago. Like this day, maybe not this day, but you know how you have a birthday? It's not your actual day, whatever, birthday, but like, it was pretty close. This is the time Jesus is going into Jerusalem, right? And he's got that great big entry of just like, bam, okay? Yeah, that's how we should always treat Jesus, guys. Jesus deserves this big entry all the time. If we're out there saying, look at what I'm doing, we should be out there saying, look at what God's doing, okay? It's a big deal that Jesus is praised. And these people were making a big deal. I mean, it's not every day that people were out there throwing their coats on the ground. I mean, people are pretty protective of their clothes nowadays. They're like, uh-uh, can't have this. And you know what's so funny, though? People back then did not have a lot of clothes. They had, like, you know, some basic outfits. How many clothes do you have in your closet? I know I have a lot. I know I have, like, over 10 coats, probably, right? Different ones, whatever, okay? And I'm sure a lot of you have over 10 different type of coats. You know, sweatshirts, jean jackets, raincoats. I don't know, okay? And these people, they probably only had, like, one, maybe two. Yeah, maybe two, okay? And they were, like, throwing it down. Nowadays, if we drop our clothes on the ground, we're like, ah, no, no! And we have washer machines. They had to wash them by hand, okay? These people were just like throwing down their coats. That's how much it would. Would you throw down your coat for someone to walk on? Do you do that ever? I don't think so. I never done that because I'm like, that's my coat. Why would I do that? I don't want to get dirty. These people were like, it's Jesus. This is a big deal. They were like showing how much of a big deal it was, all right? And it was a big deal. They were throwing down their clothes. All right? Their coats. That's how big of a deal it was. And that's how we should always treat Jesus. Like we're going to throw down our coat for him to walk on because he deserves it, right? He totally deserves it. So that's what Palm Sunday is, guys. Today's Palm Sunday, and we call it Palm Sunday because the palm tree branches, right? I really want to look that up and see if I can find if it says palm branches anywhere because I'm super curious. Let me see. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm not. Oh, wait. Ah, found it. Okay. It's in John? Okay, thank you. Sweet, thank you. Sound guy found it. John 12. Yeah, 13. Okay. So it says, the next day, the great multitudes that had come to the fast, when they heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem, took branches of palm trees and went out to meet him and cried out, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel. Okay, so the people running out of the city. Yeah, with their palm tree branches. All right, thank you, Glenn. I was looking in Mark because that was the only one besides John that I hadn't looked in. So, but I don't know if there was anything in there. It was a ways back. So, yes, that is why we call it Palm Sunday. I'm sorry. I had to be sure. I didn't want to tell you something that was just a cliche thing. So,
it's in all four Gospels.
It's in all four? The palm trees? No, it's not. I don't think so. We're just having this little discussion during this. Look. In Luke... It doesn't say anything about it in Luke. It doesn't say anything about palm trees.
Luke 19?
Yeah, Luke 19. 18 through 44. Yeah, but there's nothing about palm branches in this. Yeah.
Oops.
Uh-huh. That's why I had to make sure, because I see. But don't, that's why sometimes I say things and I'm like, Is that for sure? So guys, make sure you go home and read your Bible, because that's important. Okay? Don't take my word for it on everything, okay? You need to read it for yourself. All right. Sorry for that little, I don't know. Isn't it funny watching this all? Okay. Anyways, yeah. So that's the story of Palm Sunday, what happens. Next week, you should watch the live stream that Pastor does, because he's going to explain to you all about Easter and why it's so important, which is going to be great, because Easter is what follows this, okay? Well, the death of Christ, but then Easter, so, yep. So, yeah, that's what happened. Now you know what Palm Sunday is about. So when someone asks you, what's Palm Sunday about? You're like, oh, that's when the people took palm leaves and their coats and threw them down for Jesus to enter in. It was great. It was awesome. Yeah. Okay, it was like a parade. All right, I'm going to pray for you guys, and then I'm going to say goodbye. But I'm going to first let you know that you can go and watch these videos on YouTube if you didn't catch the beginning, or you can go to our website at calvarychapelwv.org and go to Kids Corner and slide down and click on the video for this week. I'm not sure. I think we might have the download issue fixed. So if you wanted to get the downloads, but I'm not sure, maybe just check and see, or if you don't do that, that's fine. All right, I'm going to say goodbye, but first I'll pray. All right, dear God, thank you for this day, and thank you that you died for us, and thank you that you saved us. And God, please help us to be willing to throw down our coats for you and to praise you the way that they did in this lesson today. And God, please just keep us all safe, and help us to read our Bibles and listen to the truth. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. All right, guys, I'll see you next week. Wait, I won't see you next week. I might not see you the week after that, but that is to be decided still. But yes, all right, so I'll see you sometime later. All right, happy Easter. Bye.